Now, Robyn Lawley made fashion history as the first plus-sized model in its 52 years to grace the pages of Australian Vogue. That was 11 years ago. And last week, she kicked her Jimmy Choos through another fashion barrier, headlining the first fashion show for models of all shapes and sizes at Australian Fashion Week.
Robyn is about to jet back to the US, but she joins us now from Brisbane, where she's visiting family. Robyn, thank you so much for joining us on Studio 10. Guys. Congratulations on the Curve edit show. How did it feel?
Oh, it felt so amazing. Thank you. It was incredible. I was, like, controlling my tears down that runway, and I was just so excited to see so many women of different shapes and sizes and ages and ethnicities. It's, like, been a long time coming.
And it's something you've been pushing for a really long time, Robyn. And, look, you could say this has been pretty personal for you. You've said before that your body used to be a source of shame to you.
Yeah, I mean, at 15, 16, 17, you see all these images, and they're so skinny down that runway and in fashion magazines and in all advertisement. They are so skinny, it's unrealistic. And the national average of Australia is 12 to 14 and they're not showing 12 to 14. Mm-mm. So, you know, you hold your body accountable and that really affects your self-esteem.
Robyn, and that's... Why is it called plus size? It should just be called normal. Like, there's nothing... to be inclusive of all body shapes, why is there a label on it, a plus size? Is that a problem in your mind?
Yeah, I think it is a problem. I think the fashion world just got too into themselves and were deciding that that was a normal size, and that's what I'm arguing against. It's not, and we don't need just to have size zero. You know, in America it's called size zero, but it's 6 to 8 here down that runway. You're showcasing clothes and fashion. You know, you need to show all sizes.
I think that's ridiculous to call something size zero.
It's crazy, right? It really is. Yeah. I know. Who's wearing size zero?
I know.
Yeah.
Robyn, what's taken so long? Because you've been pushing for this for a really long time. We are seeing more and more kind of diversity when it comes to body shapes, when it comes to fashion. But you just said that the average size of the Australian women is 12 to 14 and they're not being catered to. Why not? Aren't they running a business, these fashion designers? Mm. Don't they want to make money?
Mm.
Apparently not. I think it's just like time and women becoming more independent and owning themselves better and just saying no. You know, we have to say no. We want change and we want to see it. So we have to make that change happen, and that's why we did the Curve edit. Because otherwise you have to initiate change or it doesn't happen. And I hope from now on Australian Fashion Week includes a lot more diversity than it has.
You said that you got emotional at the show. What about the other models and people in the audience? What sort of emotions were running them? Was everyone sharing the same emotions as you?
Oh, I've never really done much run. I mean, I've done a few in the past in Miami and they're all cheering, but this was insane. They're all cheering and clapping and people were crying. And some of those girls have never done the runway. They've done a lot of shoots, but they haven't done the runway. So they finally got the opportunity. And I have to say, runway is pretty fun when you get to strut your stuff down that thing. You know, it's just, I don't know, it gives you a new feeling of joy. I don't know. I love it.
A new level of fierce on that runway. You've mentioned before that some Australian designers actually don't make patterns past a size 14. So is the reason why we've seen... Is the reason why we've seen such smaller sizes for such a long time, it's often blamed on cost. Is that something that you buy? Do you buy that?
No, I don't buy that at all. No, like Louis Vuitton, Givenchy, Chanel, they all have the money, they all can do it. That's such a weak excuse. And, you know, at the runway shoes, they actually fit to us. You know, there's no sample sizes really. They're all fitting to the models. Like, I've seen them all change, you know, the fabrics and the sizing right there and then. Like, they're like, oh, but sample size. And I'm like, that's not true either. The designers change to your body when you're getting fitted. So you can easily make it a 14. I was a designer. I did Robyn Lawley swimwear and it was so easy. That's just a lie.
See?
Yeah, Robyn, I'm also loving gender-neutral designs that are coming out. A lot of labels are making gender-neutral clothing that anybody can wear. Are you loving that trend as well and the direction that fashion is now going? And the direction also in sustainability, you know, making sustainable fashion and saying no to fast fashion and those sorts of things. I mean, it's on the brink of all the change that's kind of sweeping the world at the same time.
Yeah, I love compostable fashion. That's, I think, going to come out soon where, you know, it can disintegrate into the nature more because we have so many synthetic fabrics at the moment. So I think it is going into a more environmental way because it has to. You know, fashion can't be all the synthetic fabrics all the time. I think, you know, we're missing out on more organic fabrics, and I think it is going in that direction, but we have to, like I said, push that kind of thing.
Mm. All right, Robyn Lawley, so you've come home, you've given the Australian fashion industry a big kick up the bottom. You've been part of this history-making fashion show at Australian Fashion Week. You're going to back to the US, so what's next for you?
Well, we're coming into spring, my favourite month of the year, so I just can't wait. And I'm going to be gardening a lot. You know, I go into New York City for work, but I live upstate. I live in a forest, so I love going back home and I love zenning out. And when I have to work and strut myself, I do. So I can't actually wait.
Best of both worlds.
Robyn, it's been an absolute pleasure. Yeah. Thanks again for joining us, and safe travels home back to the US.
Thank you so much, guys.
Bye.